Greetings, I am Herbert Erpaderp, and today we're going to have a look at the entries from the most recent group build that takes place on my Discord server. There is a new group build up and running right now, but we'll talk about that later. The topic of the group build that has just ended was prototype vehicles. Let's have a look at the models. First up, Ringlord shared this awesome little paper Rybinsk tank. I don't know much about the real deal, but it was never built, which is perfect for this group build, being prototypes and paper panzers and things like that. I'm not sure what scale this is, but it looks to be tiny, and surely must have been quite fiddly to put together. I rather like it. Excellent work. Next, Jondhell built this Matilda 2, which has been armed with a 76mm gun. It's a converted airfix kit with the 76mm gun and side cheeks coming from a Plastic Soldier Company T-34 kit. The result is very interesting to look at, and has been executed very well. Good job. Duncan Uva built this E-100 painted in what he has dubbed the Phoenix Scheme, and you can see why. It's very bold, bright, and interesting. I like it. You probably wouldn't be surprised to learn that I like oddball out-of-the-box kind of stuff. The model is the Trumpeter 1/35th scale kit for those wondering. Looks like a pretty nice kit to me. Well done. Continuing with the German super heavies, which are certainly very popular, is this mouse shared by Panzerkampfwagen 3 Ausführung J. This is very nice. It's the Zvezda 15mm scale model, and if it weren't for the paint bottles in the background, and the note mentioning the scale, I would have thought it was a larger scale model. It looks like it's seen some action and been ploughing through muddy fields. Very nice work. Also, the Marder here in the final photo is pretty good too. Following that, shamelessly as he said, is Top Bunk Productions' version of the same Zvezda mouse kit. I really like the stripy paint scheme here, though I have no idea what it's called, if it has a name. This mouse looks like it has been well used and has been doing quite a bit of killing, according to the stripes on the barrel. Excellent work. Next up is a less heavy but no less super German tank by Monol. This is Krupp's proposal for the Panzer IV Ausführung H, and it was converted, quite nicely, from a Warlord Panzer IV kit in 28mm scale. As you can see, the sloping front plate and sides make it quite a bit different from the production Panzer IV, and it has clearly been painted very nicely too. Great job. Clement Voroshilov made this Mobilwagen. The kit is by Tamiya in 1/35th scale. It's ostensibly inaccurate for the production vehicle, but that was taken care of by entering it as a prototype vehicle, which was apparently the only one with the flak whirling turret with the four guns, which is what came with the base kit. How convenient. Not only has the kit been built very nicely, but it's also rather well painted. Excellent. Next up is Pitt, with the only plane, and also the only non-armoured fighting vehicle entered into this group build. This is a prototype JU-87C, which was converted from an unknown 1/72nd scale kit. It has foldable wings, and was intended for carrier use on the never completed Graf Zeppelin. Pitt has painted this in a different camo scheme to what would have really been applied. I quite like it. It's always interesting to see a different approach to things. Very nicely done. The only problem is, I would have liked to have seen more photos. Pax Britannica began work on this Dragon 1/35th scale E-100, but unfortunately life got in the way, as it often does. That's okay though. I didn't get mine finished either, and these group builds should be about enjoying the hobby, rather than rushing to meet an arbitrary deadline. So don't stress if you can't get your build completed in future group builds. The model does look pretty good, and Pax has even painted a smiley face onto the front of the mantlet, which is nice. And now for something not German. Eastern Union has made this awesome diorama of a KV-3. This model is in 1/72nd scale from a Ukrainian manufacturer I don't have information on. Looks like the poor KV has lost its tracks, but that just means is bunker now. Awesome work. And here's Ducking Tanker's entry. This is a very interesting and unique tank. It's the French prototype F-10 tank. This is the combination of an AMX-13 turret with a cast hull M4A1 Sherman. I'm led to believe that the production version was sold in the Middle East with a welded hull. I really like this. The blue-green is a delightful shade, and the very idea is interesting in itself, and very well executed. And finally, my incomplete entry. I managed to get so far as the base colour on the hull, and a little bit of highlighting, though there are some spots that need a touch-up, like the ring around the bottom of the turret, which I didn't realise would be visible. I've done the inside of the turret about as much as I want to, and it is pretty simple, but you can't really see much of it anyway when it's put together. I will get it done soonish, I hope. Definitely next year, though. Anyway, those are all of the entries for the previous group build, and I think they are all quite good. I'm sure you'll agree. There's no prize because there are no winners, as this isn't a competition. It's just a way to enjoy the hobby in a slightly different manner than usual. The next group build has already started, but there's plenty of time to get your own entry in. The topic is the Derptopian Army, which is a great opportunity to do something bizarre and creative, like a multi-turreted KV-2 for example. For those not aware, this is based on my City's Skylines videos in which my city is named Derptopia 2, don't ask about Derptopia 1. As the pinned message in the Discord channel will tell you, the Derptopian Army, Navy and Air Force needs you to build and mark its tanks, guns, planes, ships, and any other manner of weapons and vehicles for its ranks. Infantry would be permittable too. You may either adopt existing designs, or better yet, build a new vehicle based on a pre-existing design. Examples may range from a simple, glorious KV-2 in Derptopian colours and markings, a sensibly coloured battleship for our great navy, or maybe a Spitfire with heat-seeking missiles strapped to its wings. Anything is possible in Derptopia. You may mark and colour the vehicles however you like. We will train the troops to recognise them before sick jumps practice. Your models can be of any scale, and are not limited by time period or genre, sci-fi, fantasy, anime, historical, etc. We will accept anything so long as it serves Derptopia well. This current group build will run until the 1st of February 2019, so you have a lot of time to get your entry built. But remember, this is just a bit of fun, so don't get stressed out if you can't finish in time or anything like that. Enjoy the hobby, and enjoy creating something silly and unique. The place to get more information and to share your pictures, please do share progress, that's always interesting. The place to do that is on my Discord server. You'll be able to find the group build channel in the modelling and wargaming section. There is a link to the Discord server in the description below. Before I finish, I want to say a big thank you to Top Bunk Productions for not only overseeing the group build on my server, but also for taking the time to collect up all the photos of the end results and providing a bit of information so I could make this video. It saves me a bunch of effort and I really appreciate it. Thank you very much. So thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the Discord server with your glorious and mighty Derptopian Army creations. Farewell.